Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Kayla LaFrance. This week marks the beginning of the end for the ongoing power upgrades for the orbiting laboratory. On Friday, NASA astronauts Chris Cassidy and Bob Behnken teamed up and ventured out of the Quest airlock to kick off the last round of power upgrades, replacing old nickel hydrogen batteries with new lithium ion batteries. The spacewalking duo worked at the S6 truss on the outer reaches of the station, beyond the range of the station's Canada Arm 2, which meant that the astronauts had to carry the 400 plus pound batteries part of the way by hand. Cassidy and Behnken will venture outside again on Wednesday, July 1st, to continue their battery replacement work at the S6 truss site. Live coverage starts at 6 a.m. Eastern, and stay tuned after the spacewalk to watch the Expedition 63-64 crew news conference from Houston. NASA astronaut Kate Rubens and her Russian crewmates will answer questions about their upcoming mission to the ISS in October. On June 21st, stargazers in the Eastern Hemisphere were able to look up and see an annular solar eclipse caused by the moon passing between the sun and the Earth. For the crew on the station, they were able to look down for a unique view. NASA astronaut Chris Cassidy sent down images of their spectacular view from the ISS as they watched the phenomenon by looking at the round shadow of the moon dancing across Earth's surface. Want to see more incredible images of Earth from space? Go to the Gateway to Astronaut Photography of Earth at eol.jsc.nasa.gov. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag AskNASA. We'll see you next week.
We're counting down to 20 continuous years of humans on the International Space Station. Follow along at nasa.gov.